Dear brothers in Islam, we have started the month of Sha'ban, which is the month immediately preceding the month of Ramadan. The companions, the followers, and the followers of the followers used to put a great effort in performing acts of obedience during this great month. They would spend most of the nights praising Allah, reciting Qur'an, and other acts of worship. And they would fast of this month as many days as they can. They used to give a special attention to the 15th night of Sha'ban, because it was mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, spend the night preceding the 15th day of Sha'ban in acts of obedience and fast the following day. The acts of obedience mentioned in this hadith include reciting Quran, praying the optional prayers, praising Allah Azza wa Jal, making supplications. Most of that night, so one would be classified as he spent this night in acts of obedience. Then he would fast the following day. It was also mentioned in the hadith that on this night Allah orders an angel who would convey from Allah Azza wa Jal that if there is anyone who has a need, can ask Allah Azza wa Jal on that night and Allah will fulfill his need. If there is anyone who's asking for sustenance, Allah may give him, provide him the sustenance he needs. And if someone is asking for forgiveness, Allah may forgive him until dawn time. So the angel will continue conveying these words until dawn time. So this is a blessed night that one should not miss. Rather, one should exert his effort to stay most of the night supplicating Allah, reciting Quran, praying optional prayers, and the like. But one has to be cautious when making a supplication. When one asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something, one is not asking Allah to change his will, because the will of Allah does not change, as all the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, one would be asking Allah to change the situation of the slave from poverty to richness and the like. He's not asking Allah to change his will, because Allah ta'ala said in the Quran, ما يبدل القول لدي, which means my will does not change. So if Allah willed for you to remain sick till you die, so every time you make dua, you make supplication, it won't be fulfilled. But you make dua anyway, because by making dua, you gain rewards from Allah Azza wa Jal. A Muslim is unaware of the unforeseen, what is in al-ghayb. So he would make supplication to Allah Azza wa Jal. If he gets cured, for instance, then he would have gained two things: the reward of the supplication, and his need was fulfilled. But if Allah willed for him to remain sick, this slave will still receive the rewards of making the supplication. And be warned against a supplication that some people might call it the supplication of the 15th night of Sha'ban, which is not authenticated through the Prophet or any of the companions. In this dua, they made up, they say a phrase that a person may think from it that Allah changes his will, wal'iyazu billah, which is against the belief of Muslims. As if it means, oh Allah, if you willed for me to be miserable in my life, I ask you to change your will and make me happy and the like. One cannot use such terms. Rather, one would ask Allah Azza wa Jal, "Oh Allah, make me happy in this life," without asking Allah to change His will, because the will of Allah does not change. No matter how much amount of dua you make, or donations, or vows, the will of Allah does not change. When the Prophet asked of Allah Azza wa Jal for three matters, Allah gave him two and didn't give him the last one. Then Allah revealed to the Prophet, "O Muhammad, if I have willed for something to happen, then it can never change, because the will of Allah Azza wa Jal does not change." If one wants to say the dua on this night, let him adhere to the authenticated supplications narrated from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And most of his dua was, "Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina azab an-nar." And be warned against a fabricated hadith that some people these days send through WhatsApp and the like. They say, whoever gives the news of the beginning of Sha'ban to others will not be tortured in hellfire. This is a total fabrication. How could such a thing be true when a non-believer might give the news about the beginning of the month of Sha'ban? How can they say then he will not be tortured in hellfire? This is a fabrication. Before you send any hadith that they call a hadith or a statement to others, ask the trustworthy people if this is authenticated or not. Brothers in Islam, it was mentioned in the hadith that on the 15th night of Sha'ban, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows a special mercy upon His slaves. And by this mercy, Allah forgives every believer. For some believers, some of their sins, and for others, all of their sins, except those believers who have enmity between each other for worldly matters. So try to be amongst those who will be forgiven on this night, and make sure your heart is clear from any hatred towards Muslims, from holding grudges against Muslims. Make sure your heart is clear from all that, so you may be amongst those who will be forgiven on this night. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to keep us steadfast on Islam and to make us amongst those who work very hard for the hereafter. We ask Allah to bless us with the month of Sha'ban and enable us to perform the acts of obedience during the month of Ramadan. Ameen.